Okay, so from the last video we have reached till this particular statement. So the last part is fish 0 dot get height. Okay, and there is a so parenthesis is missing, so now it's perfect. Now we'll just write the statement. So obviously this particular statement is basically to understand that the fish has hit the ball. So obviously we'll have to return a true value. So we are just going to type return true if this condition is met, else return false. And if it is returning true, that means we'll have to increment the score by 10 now. So the next part will be to increment the score. So this particular video, the previous video, what we have done is basically we have created a yellow ball, given its given it dimensions, given it shape, given it color, and we have written the point at which it will get introduced, which is random in nature, with respect to y-axis. With x-axis it is constant, it would be canvas width plus 21, and with y it would be random in nature. And then we have created a new function, which is the hit ball checker. And if the condition is satisfied, that is if the fish touches the ball, it is going to return true, else it is going to return false. Now if it returns true, we have to increment the score by 1. So first of all, we will have to initialize a variable named score. So that's what I'm going to do, private int score. And I'm going to set it to 0 initially. So score is equal to 0. Now we have to increment the score. So for that, we'll have to write another if loop, obviously, which goes below this yellow x is equal to yellow x minus yellow speed. And below this, there is a if loop. If hit ball checker. Okay, and if it's reached yellow x comma yellow y, so these are the parameters which I've entered, and if this is true, that means the ball and the fish position is same, and that's why we have to increment score by 10. So score will be equal to score plus 10, and yellow x is equal to minus 100. So the ball disappears basically. Okay, so I think we are done, almost we are done. And now we just have to edit one line where we have written this canvas dot draw text here. So instead of score, we'll have to do plus after the inverted comma. It will be plus score. Yeah. So this will add the score variable value to the display. So plus sign is nothing but concatenation in this case. So I think we are ready to check the output. Let us check the output, whether we get the output or there is some error. So I'm just running the app. So we are not getting any errors. Now let's see whether we get the output or not. So once the mobile turns on, the game is going to get turned on, and here it is. So there's a 5-second animation, and yes, we are able to see the yellow ball. So if you see the x is same, that is behind the it is to the right of the mobile screen, so it looks like this. And when we catch the ball, we can see that the score has increased by 10. Now the score is another 10 and another 10 and another 10. And so we have successfully implemented this particular position. So we are almost done with the majority part of the game. Obviously, now we have to do the remaining part, which is if we miss the balls, the life should be decremented by 1, and obviously we'll be having a poison also. So the green balls, let us take it as poison. So if we inhale or if we eat the green ball, the fish eats the green ball, the life will be decremented by 1. So this is working perfectly. It's a random direction. And the clicks are working perfectly. Okay, so that's it for this video. Thank you so much. Take care.